Okay. I'm presenting my screen. Yeah. You're able to see my screen, right? So I hope everyone is able to see the screen.
Yeah, yeah, continue. Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Today topic is how to generate the APK and how to modify the recipes actually. Okay. For mobile application, I have created one document. In that document, I have mentioned how to generate and architecture of the mobile application. Okay, the thing is here, we don't have any native application actually. Okay. What we did is we just create an Android application. Okay, from using Android Studio, the basic Android application. So then what we did is we just take the web view of the Android. Okay, web view. There is a web view inside the Android actually. Okay, what we did is we just add the URL wherever we hosted the application, right? For example, if you want to generate an application for Punjab UAT, what we have to do is we should need the URL first actually. Okay. I'm taking the employee application. Okay, this URL you should copy. Okay. As per the document, here I'm saying there is a application will be hosted in somewhere. We will use the web view and we will render that web application inside the web view. Okay, that is the thing. That's why we don't have any native code for the Android MISH app. Whatever the web application we develop, right, that will be a responsive. That's why if I open this application in the developer window, okay, it will look like a mobile app only. Same thing you can see here. Okay. First step is you have to clone our repository front end app. Okay, then what you have to do is in the front end app. In the front end app, currently I'm in the Punjab repo. There we have the folder called Rainmaker WebView actually. Okay. The Rainmaker WebView is the Android application project. Okay. Inside the front end repo, there is a web folder. Inside that, there is a Rainmaker WebView. Okay. Whatever I am showing here, that thing actually. Okay. You should have the Android Studio or Eclipse also, it will work. You can try that also. Android Studio is this is open source. You can download from the Android website, and then you have to open the this Rainmaker web view, and then it will take some 1 minute to build the project actually, 1 or 2 minutes, depends upon the system. Okay. After that, what we have to do is, for example, if I want to generate a APK for employee, you can take the employee dev environment, you have to build a APK. That time, what you have to do is, in the Android application, we have created the build variant actually. Okay. Here we have a build variant. Okay. You have to select what we are going to build actually. For example, here you can see employee UAT debug. Okay. If I select this application, it will take some seconds to rebuild the application, and after that, if you go to this build cradle, right, there is one object we have created, employee UAT. Okay. Employee UAT. Okay. Here there is a string is there. URL. you have to copy paste the URL of your state. Okay, here actually. Okay. For example, I have selected employee UAT debug. I have to copy the URL of UAT, whatever dev environment, a QA environment, whatever you want to build a APK. You just copy and paste it here. Okay. After that, you just save this build.grader. Then what you have to do is there is a build option in Android Studio. Okay. Build bundle. Okay. APK. There is a build APK is there. Okay. You have to click this option. It will start building. The steps are I recorded in the this document. The Elzen will share you for BL team. The Elzen will share you soon this documents actually. Yeah. Here I have created how to means cloning the repo, then opening the Android Studio, going to this location, then changing the build variant. Okay, here we have to select the build variant. For example, currently we are building for employee UAT. You have to select the employee UAT build variant. Then you have to copy paste the URL of your environment. For example, Bihar, you have to update the Bihar URL. If it is Uttarakhand, you have to update the Uttarakhand URL. Okay. After that, you have to go to the build menu option. There is a build bundle. Okay. Here you have to click on the build APK. It will take some time. It's built already. The APK is generated. It will show the notification and also location also. You just click on locate. Okay. It will show you your generated APK. Okay. Show you the generated APK. And then if you want to build for citizen means you have to select the citizen UAT debug. There is two variant actually. So first after means deploying our web application, right, you will use the Jenkins to deploy our web application. Okay, after that the testers should test first, right? For that we have to give the APK for testing tape. That's why we have to select the build variant is employee UAT debug or citizen UAT debug actually. Once you select it will take some seconds and it will rebuild the project, and you have to go to the build variant. Okay. Citizen UAT is there, right? Here you have to copy paste your the URL actually, where the citizen application hosted, that URL you have to copy paste. Then the same procedure, you have to go to the build option. The step is same actually. Will take some time to build the application. This is for building the APK for testing mode actually. Testing or developer testing or the testing team testing For that purpose, we are building actually. Once everything, the QA gives a sign up, right? Then we have to build for the APK that we are going to host host for the Play Store actually. Debug mode, debug or testing mode. Okay, I think there is no question. Building the APK till putting the build variant, then we have to go to the build and generate a signed bundle APK. Here we have to select the okay. This is for assigned this one. Here you have to mention the key store path and the key store password and allies and again password. And this will come from your state actually. These keys are will come from the state. That keys you have to update. And clicking on the next, it will start creating the APK. And it will generate. After that, what we have to go is, what we have to do is, we have to go to the, our Play Store account and we have to upload this APK. That is for generating the APK for production. Production means it's for the Play Store. Okay. Once you generated the APK for any state, right, then no need to regenerate actually, because it's a web application. This is a hybrid application. The whatever web responsive web application we had developed, right, that only we are showing inside the web view of the Android actually. That's why they, once you generate it, there is no need of regenerate the APK. Okay, might be sometimes some cache will be there. That time what we have to do is you have to reinstall the application. That's all. It will work fine. Okay. This is for generating the APK. Okay. Any questions? Any question from BL side actually?
No, you can proceed.
Okay.
No questions.
Here anyone, no need of programming expertise, just opening this project and following the guideline, whatever we mention in the document, you are able to generate the APK. Next, we'll go to the next topic. Okay, e-government side also there is no question, right? I can go to the next topic, that is report customization. Mohan,
yes, Murli.
Okay.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
No. Right. I will go to the next topic, that is customizing the report. For that, the whoever attended the yesterday session, right? The same thing, same repo, the front end repo. Okay. Then we have to open the application in the IDE, whatever IDE you are using. Currently, I'm using the Atom. Okay, you can use the same Atom only, or if you are comfortable with other IDE, you can use other IDE. Okay. Then, currently, I'm in the Punjab branch. Okay. As I told you, we have to open at least three tabs. One is for compiling, and one is for running citizen, and one is for running employer. I will just run the employee side. we start run we start running the employee application. Let it run. Meanwhile, I will just explain one more thing actually. That is how to debug the Android application actually. Okay. This is not there in the topic, but I just give some idea. Okay. How you can, it will take 1-3 minutes actually. Okay. What you have to do is, for example, you want to debug the Android application, okay, using Chrome or browser. What you have to do is you have to connect your Android device. You have to connect the Android device before that you have to install the APK, connect your Android device and enable the debugging mode, and then open your Chrome browser and go to this location. It will show you the list of application, web application that is running in your mobile. Okay, here you can see the mSeva, yeah, mSeva application. Just click on the mSeva application, and there is an option inspect actually. Okay, clicking on the inspect option, it will open the developer tool. There you can see the left side is a mobile view, right side is a debugging mode actually. Okay, then what you have to do is here this whatever emulator you are seeing in the left side, right, that you can't operate actually. You have to operate from your mobile only. Okay, once you click on any application, any this mCollect or something in the mobile, it will, the screen will change actually. Here whatever you are doing in the mobile, that will same simulation will come here actually. Okay, for example, where some bugs are there in APK, okay, that time what we can do is you can follow these steps and open the developer window and go to the console and source folder, network tab, whatever you want to debug, you can debug and you can find the root cause actually. Okay, this is for debugging the application, web application inside the this Android device.
Only one word. Hello.
Yeah.
See, in Android, we have different types of version. Is there Android Oreo, Android?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
How we can test our application is compatible with the different versions of Android?
Mm-hmm. Okay, that depends on the product. Device is there? OS they are supporting? Currently, I think we are supporting latest. OS, I guess more than 5, I guess 100 means 5.0 more greater than 5.0, I guess. Okay, that I will check and I will let you know actually what OS it is supporting. That I will check actually, will let you know.
Okay.
Mostly more greater than 5.0, I guess.
Yeah, but the only component is WebView, right, from Android side.
Yeah,
so that will be the compatibility. So WebView.
Yes. WebView, which device WebView support, right?
Yeah.
Means which OS true. Onwards, that yeah. will work fine actually. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true actually. Yeah. Officially, we haven't noticed that thing actually. We have tested in many old devices also, like Carbon, Micromax. Those devices also we tested that time when we, 3 years back, when we released the PGR application, right? That time we tested, that time it was working fine. There is no that OS listing actually. I will check and I will let you know. If anything is there, I will let you know.
I think WebView list as API 1, level 1, so it is there in everything, I guess.
Yeah. Okay. Going to the this part, the application is still running. The application is starting actually. Let me try starting citizen also. Let me go back, let it run. Till that time, I will show you the PDF generation in the client side. This is about the client side actually. In the previous session, they have covered a PDF generator, right? There, they have explained the how to configure the PDF at the backend level actually. Means there is a service, PDF service, that is written in the node actually. There you can configure the PDFs thing. Okay, now I am going to explain in the client side, whichever receipts or PDFs are generated by client side, how you can customize that PDF section. That part I am going to explain. Let me take the NOC, fire NOC. Okay, each application will have the configuration. In the previous sessions, I have explained. In the configuration, there is a folder screens and there is a specs. And there is a utils. Okay, here we have the recipe PDF. Yeah. We have recipe PDF .js. There the actual receipt generation will happen. Actually, it's the client side generation. You can go to the other applications also. The same folder we will follow for generating the PDFs at the screen level. Yeah. Here also you can see. Recipe PDF. Okay, this every application the client side. Some application we are still generating at the PDF at the client side. That you can see in this level. Okay, let me go to the recipe PDF. Who was new, right? What is the best thing is just minimize whatever the function is there. Okay. Just minimize, we'll get the clear idea. Okay, what all are the things we are exporting actually. This is the this function we are exporting to outside. Okay, that means these are the util function for generating the PDF. Correct, right? There is no export, just is a constant. That means these functions will be used in inside this generate a PDF function that is exported to outside world. Outside world means you can just click on the fire NOC folder and just paste it, generate PDF. You'll get the instance of the generate PDF function actually. Here you can see there is a where and all we have used the recipe PDF that you can see here. There is a one download form button. There is a button is there, means downloading the PDF. There we are calling this function generate PDF and we are passing the state, host state, state of the application, and dispatch is used to dispatch the action, new actions if you need it. And there is a third parameter you have to send for which type of PDF you are generating. Okay, currently if you take the fire NOC or trade relations modules, right, there is three types of PDF we will generate. One is acknowledgement, correct, right? Once the citizen pay the submit the application, we will give the acknowledgement, correct, right? Fire NOC or TL acknowledgement. Okay, next one is the receipt actually. Okay, once the fire NOC or this one, which one, the trade license has submitted, after that citizen will pay for the that application, correct, right? The amount he will pay. Okay, that amount we will generate one receipt. Okay, that is second type actually. Okay, whatever you can see here, there is one option generate PDF for receipt actually. You can see here, right, right? Like that, another one is once the payment is done, okay, next the workflow will start. For example, next the document verifier will verify the documents, whatever document we have attached, Okay, if it is correct, he will forward to next level, the field inspector. Field inspector will go to the field and he will inspect the thing actually. If the fire MOC is there, means the field inspector will go to the location and he will verify this land and everything actually. Okay. Then it will forward to approver, correct? Right? Approver will see the application, whole application and whatever process, document verifier and field inspector will see, right? That he will see and he will give the approval or reject the application. If he once he give the approval, the fire NOC certificate will generate, okay? That we will call as a certificate, okay? This is the three type actually. Okay, this tree type is divided into subtype actually. Subtype means print or download. You might doing the action print of the certificate, or you might be doing the action download of the certificate. Okay, that's why you might see the two types actually, certificate download and print. Okay, this is about the receipt. Now I will show you how to customize the this is the location you got to know, right? Any questions on this thing? Okay. Okay. If there is no question, I will go to the application. I will logging into the fire NOC. Okay, Narendra, which tenant we
Batala
are
Murli.
Which one?
Tenant as Batala.
Batala, right? Okay.
B-A-T-A-L.
Murli. Hello?
Yeah.
Actually, in case of a certificate and in case of receipt, what is the actually difference? So you are making a three type of category.
Receipt means it's a payment receipt actually. I will show you the difference actually. I will take one fire NOC, approved fire NOC. I will show the difference actually.
Actually, it's only the formatting part or something
It's the data part. QR code will be there in all the type actually. For acknowledgement means it's just about our application actually. Okay, receipt means it's about the payment actually. How much payment you have done, which is a mode, those options will be there actually. What all are the tax heads has added for that payment, that okay. Will be there. The final fire NOC is a combination of acknowledgement and receipts sometime actually.
So combination. It's like three type of template you have defined and yes, all the correct. Means. All the things fits in that three templates.
Yes, that's okay. Okay. I will show you here. I will take one fire approved fire NOC. Okay, and I will show you. Okay, I'm searching the fire NOC. The status is approved. I got the fire NOC approved for this tenant. Here you can see that this is two types actually. Download and print is a two types. We are having three categories actually: certificate, receipt, and application. Okay. First, we will generate the application is submitted. We will generate the application. Correct, right? The application. This is the application. this is about your whatever form you fill, that part actually. And then if I go to the, then we will make the payment, okay? This is the payment receipt. Okay. This is the payment receipt. NRC fees, and there is no other penalty or rebate. Okay, depends upon different model, different tax sets will be there actually, interest, penalty, rebate, okay? Those part will be there. The payment information, cash, transaction, ID, and the bank name, and some note for the citizen actually. Yeah. Okay. Next one is certificate. Okay. After the approval happened from, means approved by the approver, okay, we will get the actual final receipt. Where we will have depends upon the state actually. How state wants, like that we will create the fire NOC. Here Punjab asks for English with Punjabi also. That's why the format might be different. Okay, if you see the product certificate, right, it will be a similar to what I shown in the last two actually. If I come to the certificate and all, state might be particular about their format actually. Okay, that time we have to write the that format and we have to generate. Okay. See, this is a certificate. Okay. QR code will be there. Okay, this will encrypt the file NRC number and other details actually. Okay. Next, I will go to the customization part.
Muli, in the case as the template is fixed and you are reading from a state, so in case of new form, something new requirement comes, and in that we have to create the PDF and all. So the state, like each and every things we have, it should be very specific, or every time PDF generation, you are calling some service and getting the JSON format, and then based on that, you are defining this.
Okay. Currently, as I told you, the two types of this PDF generation we are doing actually. One is client side, one is server side actually. Okay. Whatever server side we will do, that is used by the PDF generator service. Okay. The certificates. Whatever the application we created 1.5 year back, right? That time we don't have this PDF service option actually. We don't have that service. Server side. Certificate generation was not there. That's why before that, whatever application is we have created, right? That is in the client side generation actually. Okay. It depends actually how we are taking actually. If you want generate server side, you can go with the server side. If you want, you can go with the client side also. No. Both the things we are referring only one library only. That is a PDF make library. Both the sides the same application, same library as used.
Okay, so for fire NOC and for property tax, both having both will be having the different state, okay, and the template is same, right? So in that case, how it's generating means, because it will be having obviously different parameter as such in JSON. So how you are fixing the template, pushing the value into that template?
Yeah. Okay. See, as I told you, the both the models will have receipt. Receipt PDF.js, right? It will have different configuration actually. If I go to the user, different, yeah.
Okay.
If I go to the UC mCollect, the receipt format will be different actually. There also we will have different type of receipt. The format will be changed. Model-wise. Even the PDF service also will have the same thing, correct? Right? The different application of the PDF will have different the setup, correct? Right? Configuration will be different for different the module actually.
Okay. Got it.
Okay. Let me go to the customization part. Okay. the best way to customize is, I think in the ego, his current team also might be this approach. I don't know they are following or not. Just I will show you. You can ask. You can ask the question if you have anything. Currently, we have 3 points actually. If I go to the PDF generation. Okay, here you can see the PDF make is one library we are using for generating the PDF. Okay, there we have to select the first we have to select the font actually. Okay, it depends upon the state which font they want to use, that font we have to load actually. Then we are constructing the data, application data and the payment data, and some MDMS values also we have to pull actually for that. And also we have to show the logo of the state and some information, who has given the approval, those are audit information. Okay, and after that we will construct one object actually, the transformer data object. Okay, and there will be a switch case. As I told you, there is a 3 category and 6 total 6 type will be there. Certificate means certificate print and certificate download. Okay. Related to that category and type, we will have multiple switch cases. Multiple switch cases we will have. These switch cases, for example, if I'm taking the application or receipt, let me take the receipt actually, it's a simple one. What we will do is we will create the first, once it hit to the receipt download switch case, there we are constructing the file name. Okay, constructing a file name. And we are passing this information to the transform data and logo and the type to the this util function actually, get application data. Yeah. Get application data will receive those information. Yeah. Here we will start doing the PDF configuration actually. Okay. The header test, application confirmation and subheaders. Okay. Those information we will we'll start constructing the PDF for configuration. Here you can see the configurations. Okay. And property details, location details, application details, and the institutional details, and the owner's details, and the application information, amount paid. All the objects you will try to create actually. Last one actually, I shown you. This is the example you can take actually. This is the example. You can see there is a disk, the note is there, right? You can see this is the note part. Okay. This is the PDF configuration. You can see the note is the header, and this is the order list actually. Order list 1, 2, 3. You can see the order list, and after that, we will have some approved by that option. Okay. The QR code, after that we will generate the QR code, encrypting all the required information, application number, building, application status, address, date, applicant, all the information we will encrypt inside the this QR code actually. If you scan this QR code from the any QR code software, right, you will get those information, these informations. Okay. And then we will have the option to check, is it institutional, the fire energy is giving for institutional or the single owner or multiple owner, those some if condition is there here. Okay. And then you can see there is a switch case. Okay, that means if it is the application, means we don't need the this node part, right? That's why we are making those objects empty here. Actually, you can see here, those part is not needed for means application. That's why we are making empty. Okay, if I come to the receipt, right? Here you can see header text is payment receipt. Okay, and the subheader one is this part. Okay, and other NanoC detail is not needed. Proper detail is not needed for receipt. The application detail also not needed. Documents also not needed. QR code is needed actually. Okay, that part only we will construct, and then we will whatever QR code or string we have constructed, right? That here we will give to the QR code. There is a another library is there that will take care of generating the QR code. Okay. Then after the QR code is generated, then we will start constructing the means whatever we have created, right? Currently, previously we have created the objects actually. Just we are making one object, and then we are returning this to caller actually. So the caller is that switch case. Previously we see. Okay, this switch case is called that function that will construct the PDF format, and it will return actually. Okay. After that, what will happen? We'll just cross check. It's a ternary if condition. We'll just cross check application data is having some data or not actually. If it is there, we'll call the PDF make is a one third party library. There we will have the util function to create a PDF. There we will pass the application data and the file name. Okay, then it will start constructing the creating the PDF, and it will download the thing actually. You can see there is a difference. Here we are switch case is download. That's why there is a create and then cascading function download is there. If you see this type, right? Create PDF, then cascading is print actually, two types. Okay, this is given by the PDF make only. Okay. Let me, now you understood the thing, right? The flow you understood, okay? Anyhow, I go high level, I'm going. Anyhow, this is a short session. I'm high level, I'm going and completing. Means you can, if you go through the code, right? If you go keep on debugging this application, you'll get to know more idea. Okay. Let me go back to this part and go to the debugging part. Currently, I'm in NVC. Yeah. This is the ES5 code actually. Okay, that's why there is a difference. You can see this is a ES6, ES7 code. That is ES5 code actually. Because browser will understand ES5. That's why we are the React CRA will convert that part and give it to the browser. Let me go down where the receipt case is there. I will go there. Okay. I put the breakpoint here. Okay. This is the receipt case. Correct, right? Receipt case. There is. Okay. Even put the breakpoint. You can put the breakpoint here actually. Wherever you want to debug, you can put the breakpoint. Then let me click on that option. Shift. Okay. It will come this part, right? Okay. Now you will have the application data. Okay. You are having the application data. Okay. This is the actual configuration. Then okay, you need to open PDF make actually. There is a PDF make playground is there. This is a shortcut I'm telling actually. Whatever you are following earlier in the e-government, that might be taking the more time for developer. Okay, you have to open the playground. To open the playground, let us open two playgrounds actually. This is the PDF playground. the PDF make has provided copy and paste another one here. And I just previously I tried other things actually. Okay, I used to make, if I want to change anything in the PDF, right, I just copy the configuration generated by our application and I will paste here actually. Okay, this will give you the whole our application actually, whatever we generating that application it will give. You just keep on minimizing the part, whatever you want to customize, just keep on minimizing that part. Okay, table is there, then okay. This is the style actually. Okay. This is the live server actually. If I want to remove the application, just remove and I will put refresh and it will, the application part is removed. Okay. And let me control Z. Okay, I want to add new thing actually here. Okay, what I want to add. Okay, all the form, whatever you can do in the PDF make. Okay, the PDF make itself has given all the templates actually. Okay, if you want to play with your table. Okay, if you want to play with the table, there is a table example. Okay, if I want to play with means images, this is the image example. Okay, everything is there in the PDF. That's why I told open the two tabs. Okay, you can see the, you can refer the code. Okay. There is an unordered list is there. Okay, I copied the unordered list. Okay, you paste it below. Okay, paste it below. It came actually. Okay, there is some margin we have to give that we can. Okay. I'm audible, right? Everyone is able to hear, right? Properly.
Yeah, Madhuri.
Yes,
Madhuri. Yeah. Okay. Okay, I have pasted here. Okay, whatever I want to do. If I want to something, the basics part. Okay, you can copy that part, and it depends upon what the data will be. You have to put as per the requirement. Actually, just I'm showing the example here. How to play with this playground. Okay, you can add, and there is a style option is there actually. There you can style the part actually, whichever means each style means we have given the some style, right? NOC title. Yeah, that related style will be there in below NOC title. Yeah, now NOC application detail is there, right? Application detail part, if I go here, NOC title is again CSS for that part. If I go here, border. We put the same style to another also. There is a gap as came now. Okay, it went automatically, it went to next page. Okay, now customization has done actually whatever is needed. Okay, then what you have to do is you have to copy or you copy the things. Okay, you update as per your requirement actually. For example, assume like this is a note. Change the note. Okay, change it to note. Whatever you want to change as per the state, you put those things actually. Okay. Once the payment done, there is option. Whatever you want to put, you put. Then you copy the section, whatever newly added. Okay. Come back to the your the generation. Okay. Generation where you are generating the get application. Here I want to put it to put that part into recipe, right? What you have to do is here you create a new object, okay, and note and put that object here, this object, and copy the note. And come down and do spread the operation of node. Now if I run transpile the file and see, there is a node option will come in every receipt actually. Every receipt there might be one route will a node will come. Okay. This is about the customization. Okay, I think here one part I missed. Okay, let me how to copy the exact thing actually. Okay, what you have to do, right? You have to do the JSON dot stringify. Yeah, copy the application data, put inside, and there is a stringified JSON will be there. Okay. You take that JSON, take that JSON and come to JSON formatter, okay, JSON formatter, and paste that JSON here and remove that quotes actually. It's a stringified JSON, right? Remove that quotes and click on the this beautify. Okay, this will beautify the JSON. Copy and come back to the playground. Here you remove the this object part. Okay, let me remove all part. Okay, I will remove and paste it your object. Okay, whatever is there, it won't. Okay, this is not the exact one. Okay, this is the wrong one I copied actually. It's a application data. Application data. This one you have to copy. If it is big one, means there is a copy option will be there actually. Okay, from the developer window only, you will have a copy option. And go to this JSON formatter and paste that one. You can proceed. Okay, then copy and come back to the. I'll come back here and paste it. this is now the this is style and this is content. Okay, what is the difference is this playground, there is no Ravi has load actually. This font size is not load. That's why this is coming empty actually. Just remove the Ravi, okay? You will see the exact the receipt, whatever you want to, or you will going to generate actually exact receipt, okay? Then you do the customization, whatever you want to do. Go and refer this one. They have given example of all the types actually, whatever PDF make will generate. Go to the documentation, you can refer the documentation. Okay. Then change whatever you want to change, copy that thing and paste it into your configuration. Your customization is done actually. That's all. Okay. This is about customization. Any questions? Actually, this is an easy approach actually, okay? Who are following something different from the e-government, they can start following this approach because it will be easy. Otherwise, you have to change here, you have to transfer, and the citizen employee application will re-render. Then you have to check if there might be some comma has missed in your part. That's why again you have to rebuild and you have to test, okay? That will again, it will take your productivity also will go off actually. That's why this will be the better option. You can do easily, you can confirm actually everything is working, you can see indirectly, right? You can see here and you can test and you can copy that extra part, whatever you have done, and paste it into your configuration. The thing is done. Okay. Any question? Any questions from e-government? Any questions from LT?
No.
It's clear, right? It's clear, right?
Yeah, it's clear.
Then if there is no question, means I'm done with the topic. I have taken half an hour extra because it won't complete in that time. Okay, even I given the high level actually, it's not complete each section wise. I have given high level because using this one, you can create customization, you can do customization. Okay. Okay, then we can close the session, right? From BL team, any questions?
No question. Actually, your high level is also having good details.
Thank you.
So we'll be sharing all the documents anyway. Omkar will share with you formally.
Okay.
And feedback also we'll be asking for. Please share your feedback of but all the sessions and how more effectively we can do it next time. So
okay.
Thanks to each one of you who has attended the training and all who took the training also. It was very interactive sessions.
Thank you for organizing the sessions.
So yeah, anyway, Omkar will be following up on the next steps. So we'll keep in touch. Probably we'll have more conversations moving forward. Thank you.
Elson, one more thing. At 4:30, we have
to... Murli, can you switch off the recording?
Sure. Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead.
Actually, we had one more session.
One second.
That didn't happen?